Give you a little update on your M5. We had the bed ground on our weigh grinder. Pete was nice enough to stay the weekend just to grind that one and fit it all in. We did grind the top of the X-axis, but it's going to change a little bit. We're just doing it off of reference just to kind of see where we're at with everything. And then we added the headstock. We just bolted this up there today, so there's no work that's been done on this thing yet. What we're doing is, when you have a freshly ground bed, we're using the bedways to line up the spindle. So what you have here is a test bar. So it sits on three points, and then also there's a threaded rod that goes to the back end of the spindle to keep it secured to the face of the spindle. So the trick is with this test bar, you indicate this thing zero by rotating it. Actually, he's not even that far, but he's just checking the height. But what you do is you get this within zero, and then you come out here, and then you rotate it so this is also within zero. So in theory, what you're doing is you're taking the spindle and you're flipping it inside out. By doing that, you're able to take this slide and you move it back and forth, and you're able to check the side of the bar and then the top of the bar. And what you would have to do then is every time you do this, which is kind of crazy, you check that, you see where you're at, you unbolt everything, take it out, flip it over, hand scrape the head. So then that way, if it's too far up, if it's too far to the left, and you have to tram that thing in. So it's a little bit of work, but that's the only way that you could truly align the headstock to the bedways. Now, he's doing it with the cross slide right now, just because we already got it done, and he just wanted to check it out real fast to see how far off it is. Like it says, this X-axis still has to be final ground. The other thing that we have to do, too, is because we're going to put Turcite on here, I'm going to grind out on both Vs, and we're going to put either 35 or 45 thick material. Because we remove material off the bed, off the flat, we're going to be lower than the ball screw, right, for the center line. Well, we have to lift that back up, and we're going to do that by putting the Turcite in this area. Turcite's a great product. I know I talked to you about it before. The nice thing about Turcite, it glides a lot easier on that axis, so threading's going to be a lot easier for you if you do a lot of threading or whatnot. So some people love it. Some people have no idea about it, but that's the best way. That's pretty much the only way to fix these things is whatever you grind, you have to bring it back to center line. You have to cheat it somewhere. Like I says, we still have to final grind this, but we're just kind of rushing a little bit to get the headstock on here to see where we're at. The slide over here, hopefully that's not you calling us and we're ignoring you. So we did scrape this flat, and then we scraped the bottom of this flat as well. We have to lean it on its side, and then we're gonna have to do the inverted, maybe it's easier for it to go over here. So if you look down in here, we still have to grind and master that, because that would be our master for our X-axis. The gib I'm not worried about because we're gonna refit the gib. So we still have to do that. So there's a little bit more work on it. We got two guys working on this machine, so we're moving pretty far along. Oh, but before I forget, I'm gonna have you take a video of this. So this is your rear turret. If you look down here, this is a servant coupling. This is where everything sits for positioning, and it sits on these angled tanks. I don't know if you could get a good look at that. They're completely rusted up and really bad. So I'm gonna get a quote from Mazak to see how much that would be to replace. The other one is too, take a look at the front turret. Let me see if I get I don't have a flashlight on me. But hopefully you get a good look at it. I'm not standing in your way or something like that. That's definitely an issue. So you had to seal that one out, either dry rot it or whatnot. So keep in mind, maybe you should do that to your other machines so they don't look as bad as this. I don't know if it's too far gone or whatever the case is, but maybe look into that at your shop for your other machines, especially your newer Power Masters. It's not that expensive as a seal. You get it from Mazak, obviously, and then they could, you know, pull it out. It's not a ton of work, but it's a seal that goes all the way around here as well as in here. So that's definitely, definitely needed. You definitely have a problem on your machine, and I don't know, you know, and it's just over time or whatever the case is. So I'm going to get that quoted, And then also, I know a couple of companies that have used parts, so I'm going to see what the condition of the used parts are. If they are to spec where we know that they would work perfectly for you, I'm going to try to go that route as well. So as an option, but I don't have any answers on that yet. I'm trying to think what else. That's pretty much it. But the guys worked. I was fortunate enough the job canceled last week, so they pretty much cleaned up the whole entire machine on the backside of this thing. I had three guys on this thing for 6 days, so there was water freaking everywhere. But it's all good. They haven't done the electrical cabinet yet. They got to go inside and detail that. So I'll get a video once that's done. Right now, which is what it was. And that's kind of where we're at. So I'll give you some more updates as we go. Like I said, we just put that headstock on there probably afternoon. So just dial it in. I'll try to get a video of it working. In theory, what you're supposed to do, it makes it a lot easier, is you actually use the tailstock ways. Because if you're pushing and pulling a slide, it's a pain in the ass, it's heavy as hell. The tailstock base is a lot easier, and that's how we'll do our checks for in and out. And then we always reference, you know, that off of the V's to make sure everything's parallel and stuff like that, which has already been done. So, but I'll try to get some videos on that, and you know, keep you in the loop. So here's where we're at with everything. We're trying to get a good push on this thing, but I got to look at those parts, and I'll give you guys a quote on those as well. Thank you.